Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13 Developer Beta 6 is now out to developers and soon to public beta testers. If you're not seeing it today, expect it tomorrow, or it may be out by the time you're seeing this. Now, this particular update came in at 578.5 megabytes on my iPhone XS Max. It was about 500 megabytes on all of these devices, except the iPad, where it was only a couple hundred megabytes. Let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17A5556D, and that D means we're getting a little bit closer to the final version that's coming in September. And I would expect a few more versions of this prior to its release, but with Beta 6 comes quite a few little changes. And one thing I noticed right away is LTE connectivity. Now, they have shrunk the size of these icons back down, but LTE connectivity on beta 5 for me was absolutely terrible. In fact, I almost switched back to a device running iOS 12 because I might be going using a different app. I'll jump off Wi-Fi and then I'll just lose connectivity altogether. Now with beta 6, they've actually updated the modem. So there's a new modem version. So hopefully that fixes connectivity with this version if you were having those issues. Now, as far as issues, there's 41 known issues still remaining. So there's still quite a few issues, and there's only four that they actually resolved that are noted in the notes. As far as the known issues though, Chromecast may not work again. And also with shortcuts, with the shortcuts app here, the animation tab, or automation tab rather, is no longer there still. Now that is coming back, but it's still not in this particular update. Now there's a few different changes throughout this update, and I'll cover those on the different devices as well, but they all pertain to the same. It's all the same across all devices. And the first one has to do with dark mode. There's now a new dark mode control center icon. So if you tap on this, it will switch. In fact, it's actually a little bit easier to see it in settings. So if we go into settings, you'll see you can switch between dark mode. You can also use Siri to do this, but that was in beta 5 as well. Now, one change they've made has to do with the folders. And if we take a look here, you'll see the folder is more transparent when they're shrunk. They actually match the backgrounds. You can see that on this page a little bit better. So the backgrounds are matching. When you open them up, they go back to sort of a translucent, but they're more transparent when they're shrunk down. So that's a new little change. Now, for those of you that use 3D touch, 3D touch seems to be fully functional, but they haven't changed the animation back, but it does seem a little bit faster when you're using it. So if you're going into things like brightness, and again, you have that dark mode switch here, but you can add it here with the control center settings, but it's just a little bit quicker when it comes to 3D touch. Now, when you open photos for the first time, you get a new splash screen. So it just talks a little bit more about the new features as far as your photos being brought to life, all of your photos at any scale, and powerful photo and video editing. You also get a similar pop-up the first time you open the App Store, and it talks about Apple Arcade and app updates. So there's a few new changes in the App Store, and it just lets you know about those. Now, as far as the volume is concerned, they added a bunch of steps to volume. When you're moving the volume switch up and down, there used to be a lot more. They moved that back to about 16 different increments now. So if you move that up and down, it's changed back. Nothing huge, but it is a little bit of a change. And then there's more of a bug in here that's not really a feature, but it's the last thing that's major anyway. If we go into settings and we go to our wallpapers, so we'll go to wallpaper here, and under wallpaper, choose new wallpaper. And if we go to our dynamic wallpaper, they're all missing. However, if you set them, they show back up. So you can set the wallpaper or the dynamic wallpaper, but they're just kind of missing from here for some reason. And it's obviously a bug or something they looked over, but that'll be changed in the final version. Maybe this just means they've got some new ones coming. We don't really know at this point. And as far as all the changes and updates, that's really it. There's no differences between iPad that I can find or anything like that. And performance is quite good. Let's take a look at one of the oldest devices, and you'll see performance from swiping seems pretty consistent with beta 5. But everything seems to be working okay. There is a little bit of stutter from time to time, but it's quite good on older devices, as well as the iPhone 6S Plus that I have here. It's also nice and fast, and I did run a Geekbench, and we'll talk about that in a moment after we talk about battery life. And then iPadOS, I haven't seen any specific iPadOS changes yet, so hopefully there's something different about this. But there's not really any specifics yet that I'm seeing as far as changes. So everything's very consistent with iPadOS 5 or beta 5. So as far as that goes, those are the changes. Let's talk a little bit about battery life. Now it is a beta, so battery life can be hit or miss. But for me on beta 5, it was okay. I wouldn't say it was phenomenal, but it was okay. We'll wait for it to load here. And then over the last 10 days, you'll see here's the top day, 4 hours and 31 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 45 minutes of screen off time, with about 80% usage. So about 20% usage left, or 20% battery life left. So it's not great. Probably an hour less than I was getting with iOS 12.4 betas. So for me, it hasn't been great. Now that is going to depend heavily on what you're using it for. The home and lock screen with a lot of notifications, or Twitter, or whatever you're using is going to affect that. And I probably should turn off some more background activity to help with that as well. Now, as far as benchmarks, I did run it on all of these devices. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Now the Geekbench scores on my iPhone XS Max were pretty decent. 4,817 for single core, 11,312 for multi-core. We'll take a look at the other devices in the background in a moment, but if we compare this with the history, you'll see that it's okay. It's actually down a little bit when it comes to the actual single core, but it's up a little bit with multi-core. So it basically means it's going to perform as expected, as it has been with beta 5 for the most part. Now, if you wanted to reference the rest of these, here we have the iPhone SE on the far left, then the iPad Air 2 in the middle, and then the iPhone 6S Plus on the right of the iPad. So this gives you a general idea. If you're within these ballpark numbers, you're pretty good. That's it for iOS 13 Developer Beta 6 and Public Beta 5. And if I find anything else, of course, I'll do a follow-up video with any of the other major features. I don't tend to cover really small things as far as pixels moving left to right and things like that, since those are always in flux and constantly being changed and refined by Apple. Now, as far as the particular wallpaper, I'll link it in the description. And if you're thinking of trying iOS 13 beta right now, it's probably pretty safe to do so, but just keep in mind that if anything is to go wrong, you will have to restore it possibly. And if you're afraid to do that or roll it back to iOS 12, potentially losing data, then I would pass. Otherwise, it's been pretty stable at this point. And of course, for those of you that are using Apple Watch with it, hopefully the battery life is a little bit better. And let me know if you want to see a separate video for Apple Watch, if there's any major changes or significant differences. Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time. Thank you.